Hello everyone, welcome to Beachcomber. This is a totally free game that was created as part of Ludum Dare, so I'll have a link in the description to where you can check it out for yourself. Let's begin. So, here you are, on a beach. Combing it. Yeah, it's got a really interesting art style. It's very harsh. It's very, very harsh. But at the same time, it's strangely beautiful. I saw some people in the comments for this were talking about how it looked like it was kind of made out of clay, and it certainly does. Yeah, the way things move and the way they change and flop around looks very, very much like clay. It's very strange looking, but very cool. Like, look at the waves. It looks like clay. I wonder what the art process was for this. Like, was it all just created on a computer and but made to look like clay, or was it actually made with clay models that were then maybe took photos of it and then manipulated those photos, or I don't know. It's really cool looking, though. Anyway, let's see if we can find something. Ooh, that's a good sign. Ooh, am I over it? Not quite. Left? Oh, here we go. Alright, let's dig in the sand. What's down here? Yeah, you can really see the clay here, right? It's super cool. There's something I really like about it. The way actually digging with the hand and just like putting your hand in, I could just almost feel the clay, you know? Some coins. Pretty good find. Let's see what else we can find. By the way, this game apparently has 3 different endings. Let's just go up and down. Sweep the beach. Or comb the beach, as I suppose you could say. I like the sound of the waves. It's calming. Ooh. Let's take it slow. It's hard to resist the urge just to click really fast, but let's enjoy the digging. What's that? That is really cool. Unraveled and inflated itself. I wonder if that's one of the endings, or if it just takes me to a new area, or if it even does anything. Oh, I think I just used it. Yeah. Whoa. That is so cool. I just found an inflatable clay raft thing and it just took me to a freaking awesome island. Yeah, the art is really beautiful. It's like these are alien sculptures. I feel like I've just been teleported to a different planet. This looks like a little castle. Hello? Can I talk to anyone? No, I can push them. Get some music going, maybe? Can't get any better than that. I'm gonna guess that's one of the endings. Okay, I'm in love with the art style. That's just so cool. Okay, let's look for a different ending. I wonder if the placement of the objects is always the same. Yeah, this should be the life raft thing again, right? Oh, no, maybe it is different. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the coins weren't there before. I think they were to my left, and I just went to the right. Which means I should go back to the left to see what's over here. Because there's probably one over here. Oh, here it is. Okay, this time let's not take it. Let's keep venturing to the right. There's gotta be something new. I see a little peek of it. I see you. Is that an eye? Hello? What is that? What am I making? Oh, I'm, like, tearing it open. That's kind of creepy. Oh my god. Wow. You ever get the feeling that you're being followed? Well, I'm guessing going down will do a different ending. What if I just go around with this gigantic finger following me? Or can I even go more to the right? Oh, I can't. I guess I'll go down. I feel like it wants me to go down. What the hell? A massive control panel, but what does it control? I just used it. What did that do? Is that a creature with a bunch of eyes, with one of the eyes being the one I kind of like ripped open? I think it is. I think I'm inside of the creature, and it's probably not too happy. Oh, I'm playing the creature. I'm controlling the creature that I just went inside of. Oh my god, that is so cool. And kind of disgusting, because I just kind of, like, ripped open its eye. Apparently it's made out of clay. So neat. Oh. Okay, I'm seriously in love with this art style. Look at the way the buildings just, like, melt. That is so cool. I can't really avoid the feeling that I'm just, like, murdering thousands of people by crushing these buildings. But it looks really cool. So I think I'm gonna keep doing it. Can I go out here? Nah, I can't fit. I'm too big. There, I destroyed an entire town. I feel accomplished. Time to sleep, I guess. My job is done. Okay, so there's two endings. What about a third? There is supposed to be one more. I wonder if it's something that's maybe more secret, harder to find. I wonder if the money allows me to get an ending of some sort. Because the other ones do. I mean, the life raft I can take, and the ladder I can go down, but what about the money? Maybe it's just money. Nothing more to it. I don't believe you can go up, right? No. Okay, this is probably going to be the eye again. God, I feel bad for ripping its eye open. Can I back out? I don't think I can. So wait, if that hand is coming straight out of some sort of a surface and pointing upwards, and it's pointing to me, but from my perspective it's pointing down, doesn't that imply that directly above me is just another, like, flat surface? Just like the ground? But I see sky above me. Or in front of me. I don't know. Okay, so I wonder if I can do something with the finger. Like, what if I go on the life raft after having the finger pointing at me? Does anything happen? I don't know, let's walk back to the left, see if anything happens. And if not, I guess I'll take the life raft. It feels very judgmental, having this hand pointing at me. Almost like it's the protector of the beach, and it's pissed off that I've been digging in it. Okay, let's go on the life raft. It's easy just to get lost in the sound of the footsteps in the sea. Alright, come with me, gigantic hand. Or maybe not. Can I go back? No, you cannot. Okay, I really don't know where the third ending could be. Maybe it is really well hidden. Or maybe I've just simply missed something. Well, let's end with a dance. Alright, that was really cool. Yeah, I'm super impressed with it, especially the art style. Very strange sort of clay look. But it's not just like images of clay, it's obviously been processed in a strange way that makes it all black and white and full of like black dots. I don't know if that's called dithering or what, but it just looks very strange, but also very interesting. I really like it, the way things bend because they're clay, the way they mold and they bend. They fall over and they kind of, like the buildings, they almost look like they're melting, being squashed by that gigantic monster. It just looks really cool. I think it's beautiful. It's somehow harsh and yet really beautiful at the same time. Even the sky kind of looks like it's, the clouds look kind of like they're blobs of clay. Yeah, and I like how tactile it is too. I hope that's the right word. When you go to dig something up, you see your hand pop up. Let's get to a spot here. Where was it? Over here? Yeah. Yeah, you get the screen where you actually have a hand. It's just really cool. Oh, if you hold it down, you actually get like a fuller animation. If you just click it once, it does that, but yeah, it's just really cool the way the clay kind of just molds around and gets pushed around and you're kind of like scraping through it. It just feels very satisfying just to click through it and watch things change. Grab those coins. Yeah. It just feels good. Yeah, it feels good, it looks good, and it sounds good too. It's really calming to watch these weird, I don't even know what these things are, these gigantic stalks. But just to watch them, I guess blowing back and forth. I suppose they're blowing in the wind. It's going back and forth, listening to the sound of the sea and my footsteps. Yeah, it's a really cool game. Alright. Well, that has been Beachcomber. Thank you for watching.